GBP remains vulnerable despite big spending pledges from the UK Prime Minister today. So guys, really interesting speech from the UK Prime Minister today. He came across really energetic. He was almost trying to like inspire, well, you know how these politicians, they try and like inspire hope into the nation, inject a bit of, you know, optimism. And Boris Johnson was basically talking about how he's gonna do all this spending on infrastructure and leveling up the country and fixing the problems that have plagued the country over the past, you know, couple of decades. All good stuff, you've got to be said, all good stuff. And to be honest, GBP did quite like it. GBP actually at the moment is the outperformer in the G10. That could be, you know, to do with month-end flows. You've got to bear in mind, it's not just month-end flows actually, it's quarter-end flows. And GBP has been an underperformer. One of the reasons has been obviously all this concern over the lack of progress in Brexit negotiations that's been weighing on GBP for this whole quarter, this whole month. So a little bit of inflows to finish the month off, could be that. But likely a bit of optimism to do with the fact that Johnson was making all these big spending pledges today. But do note, actually, you know, all the spending he was talking about today was actually outlined back in March when we had the budget. So shouldn't really come as too much of a surprise. But the main thing I want to talk about really, guys, is the fact that GBP, despite this little rally we've seen today, remains very vulnerable. And there's two key reasons, and you know them, because we bang on about them all the time. But the first one, we're literally always banging on about it, but EU-UK negotiations, okay? We've started this month of intensive talks, still haven't made progress on any of those key issues, those key sticking points like level playing field or fisheries. Now they're quibbling over all sorts of other stuff, like they're currently quibbling over financial services, all these kind of issues, still a big gap between the two sides. So this next month, guys, is gonna be very important. Can the two sides show some signs of progress? We don't need massive progress. Remember, we got until the end of the year. But some progress would be very nice in the eyes of the GBP bulls. So, you know, if we do get to the end of this month and we're still stuck, not moved anywhere, then this is just gonna continue to weigh on GBP, because literally, remember, it's been the same story for GBP for years now. As the clock ticks, and as, you know, no deal gets closer, you have to price in a higher probability of no deal, which means GBP weakness. Number two reason, negative rates, or the potential for negative rates. Okay, so Bank of England at the moment, they've left the door open to negative rates. They haven't ruled it out, and they're currently conducting a review of the impact of negative rates. You can all speculate as to whether, you know, they're gonna decide in the end that negative rates are rubbish, like a lot of other central banks have, or if they're definitely gonna go for negative rates. But to be honest, that's all speculation. We've got to let them do their work. But the fact that they are conducting this review means that there is a probability of negative rates that's currently being priced in for 2021. And the thing is, the longer that we go with no progress in Brexit negotiations and a bad economy, the more markets are gonna price in negative rates. So, likely to weigh on GBP as well. Not looking good for the GBP bulls, guys. That is pretty much it from me for now, and I'll see you in the next one.